Good evening. A month into the volcanic eruption with no end in sight. Not only has there been damage to homes, farms, and roads, there's also damage to Hawaii Volcanoes National Park. There's volcanic ash everywhere, plus damage to at least 3 park buildings as well as roads and water lines. And yesterday's 5.5 magnitude earthquake cracked the overlook deck at Jagger Museum. That's where people would used to see Halemaumau Crater. Meanwhile, down in Leilani Estates, Fissure number 8 continues to spew lava. It's certainly been the most active and destructive thus far. My co-anchor Howard Deshevsky is on the Big Island, joins us now with the very latest. Hi, Howard.
Yeah, Marissa, we had an opportunity to go once again and see that fissure today. It is astonishing the amount of lava that it continues to pour out. And as expected, the lava from that fissure made its way all the way into Kapoho, taking everything in its path, including an estimated 40-plus homes overnight. And it's a fiery river that starts in Leilani Estates behind me and continues at this hour, pouring into the ocean. After several days on the march, lava finally reached the ocean overnight in Kapoho. This morning, the dramatic images from the air show the giant laze plume billowing up from the sea, a dangerous mixture of hydrochloric acid and steam combined with fine particles of glass. The flow claiming an unknown number of homes, as well as the cherished Champagne Ponds, a place where families have gathered for generations and a place where countless children first learned to swim.
My wife's family had this beach home down in the Beach Lots area. We always knew there was a possibility, you know. So, you know, in that particular area, there was a lot of ponds. Mostly every home there had a little pond connected to the water. But it was a situation that a lot of families went down there to swim because it was a beautiful place to be.
Big Island Mayor Harry Kim also has a family home in Kapoho. Tonight, both of those homes are standing, but they remain inaccessible, possibly forever.
On its march, it took out a lot more houses. I think we're up to about 117 houses right now, but we still have a lot more to count. So a lot of destruction going on. So we're monitoring that, also maintaining the closure areas.
Here in Leilani Estates, we have a great look at the source of all the devastation downstream. This is fissure number 8, which has been fountaining continuously now for nearly a week. We're lucky. Today, the wind's trades blowing everything away from us. But when the winds shift, we get this. It's called pyroclast. It's like a glassy, almost cotton candy light material that's very harmful if it gets in your eyes or on your skin. And that is one of the reasons that the National Guard now requires us to have breathing apparatus, eye protection, and helmets, just in case the wind changes.
There's a lot of dangers out there. I know people had seen pictures earlier of residents getting really, really close to the lava in some cases, but there's many different types of lava. And if the wind shifts, it can be very, very dangerous with SO2 levels. You can also have hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, and not to mention the lava rocks or the lava, you know, the pumice that's actually falling from the sky, too.
Now, a lot of things going on, obviously. By the way, Jim Kawahikawa, geophysicist, says fissure number 8 is actually putting out more volume, more lava than Pu'u'o'o did in its heyday. And Talmadge Magno from Civil Defense yesterday, he told us maybe about a dozen or so people still in that isolated area of Kapoho. Today, he says that number's probably considerably higher. But he does add that some of them, depending on what side of the flow they're on, can simply walk out on their own along the shoreline. And we're going to be heading back into the hot zone moments from now with the National Guard. We'll have more dramatic images, I'm sure, to share with you tonight on the news at 9 and 10. For now, Marissa, we send it back to you in Honolulu.
Howard, thank you. Another Big Island man has been arrested and charged for disregarding a checkpoint. Police say on Saturday morning, Alan Bartels of Kapoho drove up to the checkpoint on Government Beach Road. He was told it was closed, but he sped through it anyway, and officers chased him. Police say 2 county workers were standing on the road. They even had to jump out of the way. Bartels has been charged with refusing to evacuate, obstructing government operations, resisting an order to stop, and reckless endangering. He remains in custody on $3,700 bail. Well, here's another look at lava from Fissure 8 flowing into the ocean. The flow is moving along Highway 132, traveling downslope through Kapoho Beach Lots. It entered the ocean at around 10:30 last night, and as of 6:30 this morning, the lava was building up a delta in Kapoho Bay, extending a few hundred yards into the bay.
flow went into the bay about, sometime overnight. As of the last overflight, which is around noon, about half of the bay had been filled, maybe a little bit more.
The ocean entry is also creating that large plume of laze. Justin Cruz joins us now with more on that. Justin.
Thanks a lot, Marissa. You know, this time of year, we get trades 70 to 90% of the time, and that's what we're going to see this week. That's especially good for parts of the Big Island, and some parts will unfortunately continue to see the fog, the haze, the lays. Tonight and tomorrow, those trades are from the northeast and about peaking at about 20 miles per hour. And then later this week, they'll start to be more easterly for the rest of the week into the upcoming weekend. With this type of wind pattern, those trades really push that fog offshore. However, there are still areas such as Volcano, Pahala, Na'alehu, and parts of the Kona Coast that still might see some foggy skies throughout this week. Now, switching gears, we're going to talk about hurricanes right now off to the East Pacific, where we have a cluster of thunderstorms that's to the south of Mexico. This area right here may be the first named system. There's about a 60% chance of formation. It may be called Aleta. It is not a threat to Hawaii, but a gentle reminder that it is hurricane season. Coming up later, we'll talk about some South Shore surf. Marissa, back to you.
Justin, thank you. And if you want to learn more about the impacts of volcanic ash and fog, there are a couple of community meetings coming up. There's one this Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. at the West Hawaii Civic Center in Kailua Kona. Then also another one on Thursday at 7 p.m. at the Cooper Center in Volcano. Then next week, Thursday the 14th at 5:30 p.m. at the Ocean View Community Center. We have more information on our website, khon2.com. And make sure you stay with KHON2 on air and online as we continue to track this volcanic emergency.